Good morning, class. Happy Monday. Today, we are in our small read. We're starting Unit 3-4, and we're talking about animal adaptations. Our genre this week is going to be expository text, which is facts, 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 facts. Just tons and tons of facts. It's going to be written a lot like a science book. Well, check out that picture we have on page 132. That is a chameleon. Hey, hi, I'm a chameleon. Have you ever seen anyone quite like me? Now, it's a chameleon, but he actually looks like what? It actually looks like those leaves. God gave it an amazing animal adaptation. It can actually change color to match its environment. We call that camouflage. Here's how I adapt to survive in my environment. See my skin color? I can change it. Changing my skin color helps me camouflage me from predators. My long tail can wrap around branches. How do you think that helps me? Long tail wrap around branches, well, it can help him climb and look like he's just a leaf hanging there. Pretty cool when a bird or some kind of other predator wants to come along and eat him. That's not an animal, that's a leaf. I don't eat leaves, so I'm gonna leave this thing alone, and that saves him. What other kind of animals do you know that have cool animal adaptations? Well, that tail thing triggered in my mind a funny animal that scurries around my yard sometimes. It actually kind of freaks me out. It's called a possum. And a possum has a prehensile tail, which means its tail can wrap around branches as well. I don't know if you knew this, but possums actually like to sleep hanging from tree branches. They wrap that tail around there, and it's like they're in their own hammock, just laying there, hanging in the tree. Well, that tail helps them. That's an animal adaptation. I like to call it God's cool creation. All right, so this week we're going to talk about animal adaptations. Let's get our vocabulary first. I'll pull you a little bit closer so you can see a little bit better. The first word is camouflage. And if you're looking in your books on page 134, you can see that that butterfly or that moth is camouflage. The definition is hidden by looking like its surroundings. It is hard to see the camouflage insect because it blends in with the leaf. Now, I'm making this video on Parent-Teacher Week on a Wednesday, and I have two more meetings with parents, and then I'm actually going to go, and I'm going to get all camouflaged. Yeah, I'm going to put on some hunting pants on. They're green with leaves on them. They look like I'm a big leaf pile. I got this big hunting jacket. I even got this hunting scarf. It kind of looks like a face mask. Covers me right to here, all the way to here, tucks in under my jacket. The only thing that isn't camouflaged on my body is my two eyeballs that are looking to see if I can hunt. And today what I'm gonna hunt for is some deer. How exciting. Now why would I wanna be camouflaged when I'm hunting deer? Well, if I was hunting in my living room, I would have the advantage, right? Because I know everything that's in my living room. And if some crazy animal walked through my living room, I would definitely notice it. But it's vice versa for me. I'm actually going in the deer's living room. I'm gonna go in the woods where the deer knows and sees everything all day. And all of a sudden, if he would see a human being, well, you ever know what happens when an animal sees a human being? Boom, it runs the other way. Well, what good am I a hunter if all the animals are running away from me? So I'm gonna camouflage. I'm gonna make myself look like the woods, and then I'm gonna stand really, really super still so that the deer can't pick me up. And I'm gonna try to make sure I don't smell. No bad breath, no body odor, so the deer can't. Now, God's given these deer all these amazing animal adaptations so that they can stay safe. And so I got to think of all the things that they have. Their big nose, their huge eyes, their radar ears. And I got to be super quiet. I got to smell super like the woods. And I got to look like a big old pile of leaves if I want to have a chance to even see the deer and hope that they get close enough for me to be able to hunt them. How exciting. And where do we learn to be camouflaged? Well, from awesome insects and birds and chameleons and other things. All right, number two, dribble. To flow or let flow in small little droplets. We got this dribble in a sink. I don't know if you've ever had a leaky faucet, but this is a great picture. We got these little dribbles of water. The sentence in our book says, water dribbles from a leaky faucet all night long. Drip, drip, drip. That can be annoying if you don't get it fixed. Our third picture is of that amazing owl. The owl has extraordinary ability to stare for a long time without blinking. No movement at all helps the owl be a predator. Now, an owl wants to stay very still and it's looking with its eyes to see anything that's moving on the forest floor, like mice. Owls love mice or chipmunks or moles or anything that it can eat on the floor. Very unusual, remarkable, extraordinary, extraordinary, I like to say. Extraordinary is extraordinary, and an owl is one of God's creations that is extraordinary. Our fourth one is poisonous. Poisonous. And here we see something that is harmful or kills by chemical reaction, and you have this mushroom. A lot of time in God's creation, if you have something that's brightly colored, like some of those tree frogs, poison dart frogs, you don't eat them. They're super colorful is a good indication that they're poisonous. Well, a lot of times people call snakes a poisonous snake. Snakes are actually not poisonous. They're venomous. A venomous snake bites you and injects venom into you, not poison. So let's try to clear that up. I know those are little kids that think that, but big fourth graders understand. Poison. Poison is something that harms or kills by chemical reaction. Now, we have some of these things probably in our houses. Some types of cleaners are poisonous. Don't swallow those cleaners. All right. And the next page. Pounce. The bobcat. That's a bobcat there. The bobcat likes to pounce on fish in the river. Pounce is to leap or to spring suddenly and attack. Roar! Jump, leap, spring, and attack. He's looking to, well, this guy is looking to catch some fish. The picture in our book didn't show you the river, so I really like it that they put a different picture up here so that you can see him pouncing in the water and trying to capture something. Maybe you pounce on your little brother or sister when you're wrestling in the living room and having fun with them. Six is a predator. The leopard is a fierce predator that can catch most animals that it hunts, because a leopard is super fast. A leopard can actually run, not for long distances, but short distances, up to 70 miles an hour. That's like your car driving down the freeway. That's how fast those leopards can go. And a predator is an animal that lives by hunting other animals. He's got to run and chase. It kind of looks like a small deer there. I'm not sure exactly what that animal is, but he's got to run and chase that. And if he doesn't catch it, it doesn't eat. Now, we do have some predators here in Milwaukee, and that's kind of a little bit annoying by my house. I don't know if you have any by your house. They're called coyotes. And when a police officer drives by my house and the sirens go, I can hear the coyotes in the woods howling back because they think it's a coyote. And they're like, oh, ho! And those coyotes, I never hear them during the day. No, a lot of predators in our area hunt at night. And a coyote would love to catch a rabbit. Or would love to catch a raccoon, or a possum, or even a mouse to eat. And I guess the coyotes catch a lot of deer as well. And so those are predators. They gotta hunt to get their food. Well, if we have predators, we must have prey. What's prey? Prey is an animal that is hunted by another animal. In this case, the Venus flytrap. Have you ever seen these things? If you touch the inside of the flytrap, it snaps shut. And the Venus flytrap tries to eat its prey, these insects or these ants, and they catch it with their sticky leaves. The last one, vibrations. Vibrations are rapid motions back and forth, up or down. And this is a musical instrument. Eric plucks his guitar strings, and the vibration of the string, it moves, and that sends off sound that we can hear, causing vibrations of the strings moving quickly back and fourth. Can you think of anything else that might vibrate? Might vibrate. Well, we have all sorts of instruments that vibrate. I don't know if you knew this, but inside a piano you actually have strings. When you press the piano key, it hits a string that vibrates in there. All right, guys, turn the page. Our story is entitled Animal Adaptations. I'm going to read it to you, but I wanted you to start thinking ahead of time. What are some adaptations that this skunk has? We do have skunk here in Wisconsin. And what about some animal adaptations over here of these? I forgot what they were. I believe they're caribou. Yeah, they are. They're caribou. These caribou have, we don't have those in Wisconsin. They like the tundra really cold. Well, we'll read the story and we'll take our assignment in the next video. We'll catch you then.